Did you know that Farmington Hills has a program to address traffic concerns in your neighborhood? And you can actively get involved in the improvement process. It's called the Traffic Safe-te3 program. And it's an acronym for safety awareness for everyone through education, enforcement, and engineering. The program allows city staff and the community to work together to create safe conditions in our residential areas for motorists, bicyclists, pedestrians, and children. The Traffic Safe-te3 program can address issues such as speeding, pedestrian safety, cut-through traffic, sight distance issues, and collisions. Here's how the program works. It's divided into three phases which must occur in the following order. Phase one includes identifying the problem, gaining support from a core group of residents, and collecting benchmark data in the form of speed studies or other traffic engineering information. If there is interest, the city hosts an informational meeting to present the program. From the informational meeting, a subgroup of residents or core group will be formed to work with the city to gather information. Speed studies, traffic counts, and other data will be collected at locations identified by the residents. All of the data gathering will be done in a partnership with city employees and resident volunteers working together. Phase two is the development of an education and enforcement plan based on the specific findings of the field review. Did you know that most violations of traffic ordinances within a residential area are by the residents themselves? Educational programs include distributing a letter of the findings to encourage drivers in the neighborhood to be more aware, and radar speed display equipment will be used to remind motorists of their speed and to slow down. Police enforcement is also a significant part of the process and takes place after the radar signs have been posted. The effectiveness of these programs will be monitored, remeasured, and reevaluated. If the measures prove to be effective and the speeding situation is reduced, the core group will notify the neighborhood of their success and encourage the continuation of safe driving. If, however, these measures prove ineffective, the location then qualifies for consideration of phase three of the program. Phase three consists of the installation of actual physical speed control devices in the roadway. Because the devices are designed to make it less comfortable for the motorist to speed, it's extremely important that these devices only be installed after exhausting the alternatives provided in phase one and phase two. These devices may include speed humps, traffic circles, slow points, pavement markings, and traffic control signing. A plan will be prepared by the city and presented to residents to allow their input to be considered in the final design. Neighborhood support is absolutely essential during the entire process, requiring at least 75% of the residents in the area to support the plan. So, how can you get started? Head to fhgov.com to find all the tools you need to make your neighborhood safer.